So we're back with Mega Man 6, and this is the last of, like, the classic early 90s Mega Man releases on NES, and so the storyline of this one is a bit different than the others. It starts out with the setup of just, they're having a tournament of all of the strongest robots in the world, and the sponsor has manipulated all of the robots to take over the world, do evil things. And so Mega Man steps in and wants to stop them. You know, it's basically a Dr. Wily-esque situation, except it's not Dr. Wily, it's some mysterious stranger. And we have to step in and deal with it, I guess. So I'll do... No, I don't want to do Wind Man first. This game is pretty challenging to play first time through. I find it very satisfying after, you know, playing through it a few times and getting used to it. First time was pretty rough, though. It's pretty hard. The big difference here, or just the biggest difference, because most things are kind of the same, is they changed how Rush works. And so, like, you could tell, like, from the box art, Mega Man has, like, this, you know, red power armor with jetpack capabilities and stuff. And that's actually how the game works, is you, it's not like a crazy, like, late game ability or something like Mega Man X's fully upgraded power armor or anything. Rush, oh jeez. That part always is a little dicey. So Rush has been changed in this game to where he's no longer like a little, like, companion that vehicle that you ride on. He's now a power armor adapter for Mega Man to give him new abilities. So you can use it infinitely, but you also have the drawback of when you're using Rush powers, you can't slide, which is a pretty big drawback, and you also can't do charge shots. You can still fire your normal shots as Rush, but you can't do charge shots. But you'll see, because we'll have to use the new Rush abilities extensively later on. That's kind of the only real, like, big shakeup here. Like, everything else is pretty much the same as it was. You know, you got the charge shot, you got the slide, you have a host of power-ups that are pretty standard and similar to other ability, like, weapons from other Mega Man games. A lot of the enemy AIs work similar to past enemy AIs, just with new tech, new sprites. Like that guy. But also, one of, like, little, like, gimmicks to level design and theming is, since it was, like, it was a world tournament of robots, so all the robots were, you know, presumably from all different places across the world. And so each level that you play through, like each of the Robot Master stages, take place in a different country. So this is supposed to be China. hints, I guess one of the things that really stands out to indicate that it's supposed to be China is that you're fighting against those robot pandas. So, like, just, like, the most, like, basic of, you know, suggestions and hints that of what country you're in. So this guy has the same, like, the same ability that, Dustman did, which he would, like, you know, suck in air and pull you towards him. But unlike Dustman, you can actually damage him while he's doing it. It's just, he can pull you in much, much faster, so it's pretty dangerous to do so. But all in all, like, a fun fight that's not, like, not too challenging, not too overwhelming. I mean, it's pretty overwhelming the first time you fight him, obviously, but it's not too bad. So there's like a little Mega Man sprite over Windman stage now to indicate that I have all of the items from that stage, because a new feature with this game is each, well, not every stage, but some of the stages have like alternate routes with alternate endings. So depending on where you go, which path you take, you'll get a power-up, which, you can see down at the bottom, there's, like, icons for a little, for four little, slots, and that's for the beat upgrade. Not that. And when you unlock Beat is the same as he was in Mega Man 5. And you have to unlock him by just finding the alternate routes in the four stages where there are Beat power-ups. That's basically it. But again, like, Beat is not especially useful, except in maybe a couple of tight spots where you're, you know, you have like a little ace in the hole. So, like, based on the architecture outside, I think this is, like, I don't know, some kind of Middle Eastern country or Russia or something, I don't know. So it looks like Flame Man himself, his design, almost looks like his head is wearing a turban. So that's what I think it probably is, but who knows, it's not really all that important, because these games are not, like, really all about, like, there's, like, some of the lore is, like, fun to engage in, like, there's, like, comic book series and things like that, and those are all fine and good, but, like, ultimately these games are not, like, the focus being on story. It's about gameplay. So little details like that are more or less irrelevant. Pull out the Windstorm. So this guy's a little bit like Flame Man, but or Heat Man, but a little, this is somewhere between like Flame Man and Heat Man, but less relentless than the two of them. Or maybe just a more aggressive version of Wave Man from Mega Man 5 would be a relatively close approximation of Flame Man's abilities. Okay, so yeah. Oh no, that's not the right one. Well, that's okay. Plant Man is not weak to Flame Man's ability, but that's okay because Plant Man is kind of a pushover anyway. So we'll just plow through him. It just might take a little bit longer than it would with the proper ability. So these enemies are just like the little flying orbs from Mega Man 5, except now they have a weak spot mechanic where you can only hit them when they're eye is exposed. Oh jeez. I think this guy will go down pretty quick to these. So apparently the fire blast in this game is exceptionally powerful. I don't want to overuse it, but basically anything like mini bosses where I gotta recharge here. So unfortunately you have to like kinda sorta watch, like you have to watch the whole cutscene, but you have to like watch half of that cutscene every single time that you want to transform into Rush. It's really annoying. Like any one of these like mini bosses where it's like you have they don't have iframes, you can just kind of spam as much damage as you want into them. Flame blast kind of just tears through them. How did that miss? It was being so careful and somehow still died. And you put the checkpoint like before the second mini boss, you gotta fight him again. Which is really obnoxious. Sound like I have infinite lives and infinite fire blast here. If it wasn't obvious, these piranha fish will, their jump heights will scale to whatever height you're at. So if you jump high, then they'll jump just as high as they need to be to hit you. Okay, really? Like, I clipped through that floor. I hate this level. Like, that's the only part of this level that I hate. It's the only part of this level that's challenging. Which is really strange, considering it's like, it's Plant Man, and like, you know, plants in general are not known for their mobility, and the only part of the stage that's difficult is like the focus of the stage is aerial bouncing and jumping. made it that time, but like I felt like I didn't deserve that. That like I should have like fell off and not even like hit the platform. Like the hitboxes on these platforms are a little bit finicky. So Plant Man is your token barrier boss or shield boss. Creates an impenetrable shield and then runs around a little bit and then creates another one. And that's it. That's all Plant Man ever does. And the shields are, you know, pretty easy to jump over, so. The only difference between this and fighting him with his weakness, which is Blizzard, is you just do more damage. And even then, not that much more. Okay. See, I always forget where rush parts are. And like all the games, it's just too much shit to remember. I can't remember it all. So it's good that we have both the rush jet and the rush power adapters now. So I don't have to worry about that stuff anymore. I can basically go anywhere I want to. Because I think for the most part, all of the like here's Rush Jet. So Rush Jet, as you'd expect, is exceptionally useful. But you can see from the bar, you have like very limited use of it per jump. And also, you have to consider your momentum. A secret. I don't even remember what it is. It's not important, but now I'm just curious since I'm here. It's a life. Good. So when you're falling and you pull out Rush Jet to start using it, like first you have to like counter your downward momentum and then you can start going up. Which, at best, you can just slow your momentum to maybe a stop in midair before you run out of energy and then start falling again. So, at best, a, like, sort of a hover. Unless you're, you know, on flat ground and you jump upwards and then you start jetting upwards at the height of your jump, then you'll go upwards. But only for a short distance, so it's not especially overpowered, but it's like, because you can't stay in midair for very long. And there's that NES respawning enemies thing again. Combination of having to pause and reselect a new mode every time you want to change modes, which is not a new thing, that's how Rush worked in other games, but that combining with that, you have to like watch like part of the cutscene every single time you want to change to Rush is really tedious. But what are you gonna do? So now we're gonna use fire on the ice guy, because of course, why wouldn't you? And of course he's invincible when he does that rolling attack. You're lucky he won't do it too much, but... like, for how flaccid the flame blast looks, it's really strong on a lot of enemies. So now we got double attack, which is not overly useful. It's just weird to hit with. Alright, I guess we'll do Tomahawk Man. Which is like clearly like America World. Western America World. Complete with cowboy robots. So it's like a cowboys and Indians, like Western Canyon themed level. Which is cool, I guess. It's just weird for Mega Man to have like these like world tour themed stages. That time. This is an alternate path you could take with the jet, but it's not really a path that has like some secret that you'd need, like some kind of power up. It's just kind of like an alternate route that's easier and has a nice little payoff at the end, but there's not any kind of power up or anything there. Just gonna use Flame Blast again. It just tears through mini bosses. I want to go both ways. So there's this hole in a wall. But you have to be like right on like the cusp of like basically standing off of the edge of the floor to be able to hit that. Then Proto Man shows up for like the one time he does, and he gives you that mysterious device, which is now in the inventory there. It's a long time coming that they finally added like a weapon, like energy power up to Mega Man, and that's what that is. Alright, I'm having trouble selecting what I want, because the cursor just kind of goes where it wants. So now, with that power-up, which is totally optional, you have the ability to whenever... oh, really? It bounced off his face from the other side. You grab weapon energy, and it'll just, like in Mega Man X, automatically, which came out, around the same time as this game, depending on what region you're in. I think Mega Man X actually came out first in America before this game came out in America. So it kind of felt like a downgrade, but you know. You can pick up weapon energy, and just like in Mega Man X, it'll just be added to whatever weapon in your inventory has the lowest amount of energy. So it'll fill it automatically without having to switch to it. Which is great. I'm glad they were able to figure out the tech before they retired the series forever. Tomahawk Man is usually really aggressive. I think it's the least aggressive, one of the least aggressive Tomahawk Man fights I've ever had. Just kind of stood in one spot, just threw projectiles, which is kind of weird for him. He usually hops around, he's kind of hard to dodge. Also a cutscene, weapon get cutscene, pretty nice. I appreciate that. It's actually kind of sort of like, okay, see, Yamato, yeah. It's kind of sort of like the one they have in Mega Man X, isn't it? Impregnable Fortress. This is obviously your Japanese boss. Fire projectiles with power suit, but they like have very limited range, so it's like power is not especially useful, especially considering that you can't slide, so you're slower, have less mobility options. All right, what do I use in this guy? Just pull out flame blast, see how that works. Seemed to work all right. Every time. Why? So that was the other path I could have taken if I didn't take the detour. And we have another forking path. Slide at the end of one screen, your slide will finish on the next screen. So that's what happened there. I couldn't stop myself from sliding on the second screen and just fell into the pit. Even know if this is the right path. I could have. This may be the wrong Yamato man. I gotta fight him again. Don't know. I think it might be. I think he's weak to the tomahawk. So Silver Tomahawk is your best weapon in this game, I would say. It's pretty strong, and you can reach pretty much anywhere with it. And there's at least one boss that you encounter later that is basically designed for you to fight him with the tomahawk. Yeah, fight him. You know what? I think I'm just gonna skip getting the beat parts. Cause I never even used beat in this game anyway. Kinda sucks, actually. I don't feel like playing that stage again. Sliding issue is obnoxious. I think it's only this game. Mental note, don't slide off of the edge of any screens unless you're super confident on what's on the other side. So just instantly kill you. Change the slide in this game, because the other game you could the other games you could like change direction in the slides. I think there's all kinds of stuff you could do. To defeat it, to get past it. Really weird. Oh, that's useless. And more often than not, Eddie's useless. It's just kind of a thing. Jetpack exclusive E-Tank. Unfortunately, they put the path that forks to the alternate Nightman just right there. So, you can't miss it. And if you don't have the power up, it's cool, you can just avoid it. Now, Nightman's gimmick is that he has that shield up and you can't shoot at him through the shield. You have to wait for him to fire the mace at you, and then you can hit him while the shield is moved out to his side. But if you use the Yamato Spear, which is his weakness, it just penetrates the shield anyway, so. As you would think, like, a spearman versus a knight swordsman or something, then they would get defeated because they outrange them. There's nothing you can do. Just all in all, the knight's move is kind of lame. It has very low range. And just isn't as good as all the other powers that you have in this game. Like the Yamato Spear is a decent replacement for the Buster Shot. I'll take that. Why not? Fish. This guy just sits here and just... You either take the hit or you can just wait for a second. It's one of those patience sections. So it's weird that, like, you know, this is a Centaur Man stage. And Centaur Man is not in... Not an aquatic... Oh, God. That was my mistake. I gotta roll it back to the beginning. It's not a water enemy or anything, and there's nothing, like, aquatic about its attacks. It's just, an aquatic-themed stage for some reason. Also, if you can hit that enemy, you can pass by it real quick. It's one option. So this is your obligatory Mega Man underwater platforming section. And then this is pretty cool. It's your like your reverse underwater section. Where the water's coming from the top. I'm gonna just use Jet to bypass it, but... Like, the gimmick here is that, you know, the enemy shows it off that when you jump in the black, then it's like normal gravity, and then when you jump in the water, it's low gravity, so you can propel upwards. Those guys can only be destroyed with a full charge shot. Once again, Eddie, you've let me down. How could you? So there's a bunch of these like little hidden like Metroid pods that are just hidden on the ceiling sometimes. You just gotta know where they are. You can't really see them coming. So if you don't have Jet and you can't make that jump, then you just fall down and there's another boss door right there. So it's fine either way. It's just the only difference that if you complete this one, you get the beat parts, and the other one, you don't. He didn't do the move that time, which is kind of weird, but, Centaur Man is, like, this game's Flash Man, where he can freeze you in place, and then you're powerless until he runs into you. So you get the Centaur Flash, which is exactly like the Gravity Hold. It's a screen-clearing move. Now we're approaching the quote-unquote end, where we're gonna tackle Mr. X. I feel like some of the backgrounds of this stage are like amazing for the NES. I mean, granted, this was like 1993, so like if you were gonna put out an NES game in 1993, it probably should be amazing if you want to get noticed at all. So yeah, because it's like this game and like Kirby's Adventure are like the pinnacle of NES tech, in my opinion. Because they were like the last, two of the last games that they ever, that were ever put out for the NES. Where's, okay, Thunder Flash. So yeah, Thunder Flash is like a screen clear, but only on certain enemies. It doesn't work on all enemies or does enough damage. You may have to like fire multiple shots to hit some enemies. But scenarios like this, you can just pretty easily just do that. Save just some time and effort than doing other things. Because you could probably like tag most of those enemies with like tomahawks. But since our flash isn't especially useful, particularly on bosses, and tomahawk is useful on a couple bosses, so best to conserve that when possible, when you can just use where you can use something that's less useful. It's down here. Oh yeah, that's the other path. That path is a nightmare to get to. I mean, the reward is pretty good, but like, it's just too much. Yeah, those bosses just kind of, models just kind of pop in. Alright, I think it's... yeah. Yeah, their weak spot is like, really tiny. And they just kind of like arbitrarily change direction. So, these guys are kind of rough. Oh, jeez. I might die here. I'm gonna just use an E-tank. And that's all there is to it. It's like you have to hit it like right in the middle of its body to be able to do damage. Okay, these stages, like, where is Mr. X exactly? Like, is he in outer space? Or is it just, like, somewhere on the planet where there's a really nice view of the sky? Probably best not to worry about it. These guys will just follow you forever if you let them. I just noticed, is it me or does it look like Mega Man has huge breasts? So it's like shading underneath the middle of his chest. It's especially pronounced there. It's like he's wearing like a red nightdress or something. Even the box art kind of makes it look like he has breasts as well. Yeah, this boss is basically designed for the Tomahawks. Oh my god, I can't believe I died. Well, this is gonna be rough going forward. Jet and get a shot. Oh. But like, to be safe, you have to be like way far back here, and like you're gonna get hit by rocks eventually and keep strafing up and down. Jesus. That is just a nightmare if you don't have Tomahawks. Tank there, but I do already have 5, so I'm feeling okay with that. Put a lot of alternate paths in Mega Man 6, many of which are not that important. They just, like, are kind of like subjective alternate routes that are that may or may not be easier or harder. Some require certain power-ups that will yield some kind of reward at the end. And a few of the paths, like, are, you know, like the ones where you get beat parts. Like, those are important. But other than that, most of them aren't that important. I don't remember this guy's weakness at all. Is it this one? No. There it is. Get some tomahawks. I think the way it works, it either gives you energy for the lowest ability, or it just gives you energy for the next ability on the list that needs energy. So I didn't want to risk it, just switch over to tomahawk. Oh, there's that as well, as a drawback. When you land from a jump, there's like a couple of frames of like landing in place where you may or may not be like kind of like locked in place for a couple of frames without being able to move. So just in general, your mobility options are a bit more limited when you're wearing a power suit. Aside from the obvious, like, you know, being able to fly part. This is where Flame Blast actually comes in handy, because it's like, it hits the exact spot where you want to fire. I guess that's what that's supposed to be for. Oh jeez. So you can use the power suit to knock blocks on top of those tubes to block those birds from spawning. I mean, at this point, I'm just, like, tired of, like, constantly switching to power suit and to normal already that I just... Anytime I don't need to switch, I just don't want to. Explode. You just kill them before that happens, or avoid them. So it's like a trick, is they want you to hit that block to stop the birds from spawning, but then when you do, you block off the E-tank. Could do both, but it wouldn't make sense. Thank you. minutes to get to the boss, so now we can just die and respawn at full health and do this for reals. There's Mr. X. Can use Fire Blast. He also has a very particular like hitbox. It's like right on like the sides. And there's also like just like an exceptionally narrow window where you can like jump out of the way of the blast without getting hit by the sides of the spikes. It's nuts. Dr. Wily. So that means that Wily had, because it wasn't even a different person, it was the same person, and he was basically just Dr. Wily with a mustache on. Or, I guess in this case, just a pair of goofy sunglasses. And that was enough to convince people that, hey, this is a different person. Otherwise, he looked identical to Dr. Wily. It was so weird. So what this means is that Wily had two castles. Which to me is a bit nuts. Oh, jeez. So talking about the moment, like, you'd have to, for that part, it's, like, really specific. You have to time your jet at just the right time to be able to get enough momentum to stop yourself from falling onto the spikes. So you have to go, you have to start jetting like way earlier than you think you would need to. Cause it's not the most refined like jet mechanic that I've ever seen in the game. It's pretty unforgiving actually. So like maybe right here, yeah. And then do it again even harder. Yeah, this is a pain. Oh god. I don't remember why I just used Jet. Did they playtest this? Like, just this screen? Because I feel like the frustration on testers would be indicative of, like, what, like, the just a huge problem there with constantly switching between power suit modes. So like I had the jet going for the entire screen and I could not stop myself even close to the amount needed to get to that little hidden wall there. Jeez, that was like a couple of frames later than the first time I did it. And that was like not even close. It's ridiculously precise. Like, honestly, it's almost... It's probably easier to just... Oh, jeez. I hate this. It's just this one, like, half of a stage that is just brutal. This is like, it tests your expertise with this jetpack mechanic, which is like the least intuitive thing. And then your patience on top of that. And then pretty much after, it's smooth sailing. Ah, oh, that was the wrong... Okay. We'll do this again. Like... I haven't gone through, like, the entire, like, intended path in a long time. Like, it's probably been years since I've done that path. I usually just do the secret path that's on the side. And like, you know, that path, you know, once you get into that wall, it's like, you know, piece of cake. You're basically one and done. And that's arguably easier to just do that than it is to go the intended way because of those little sections where you have to time your jumps just right. Like, it's more forgiving to get to that breakable wall than it is... See? And now we're home free. It's like, why'd you make the optional path, like the real path, easy, like harder than the optional path? Oh, right. I always forget about that. They troll you. It's a fallaway floor, so no E-tank for you. It's a very cruel thing to do. Wait, I got full energy. I'm eating this crap. Hit him like in the face between his jaw and between his forehead. On top of that, the you can rapid fire Yamato spears like the Mega Buster, but every time you fire it, it has like a different height to it because it kind of like goes in like a little miniature sine wave, so the height of your blast may change and you'll miss just because the height of your unintended height of your Yamato spear doesn't match up with the hitbox. Slide in that way. Where am I at? I got 2 lives. Probably just take this death. What boss is this? I feel like you killed him on the first try, but I overestimated how much damage I was gonna take doing it, so I just wanted to be safe. This is like a callback to Mega Man 2. Like they had the, I think it's the last time I've seen this, where they have an enemy that can, you know, push and pull you away. The only problem with it is they put these fan enemies in spots where if you're just kind of cautiously going through the level and you didn't know they were there, then they would just pull you directly into the spikes. So it's kind of like a beginner trap thing, which I don't, like, I think that was the point, is just to learn from your mistakes, but I don't like the idea of learning from your mistakes being an excuse for making something that's deliberately punishing to someone who, like, could never see it coming. So this game's boss rush kind of just uses these generic brooms. Let's see, flash. Hey, the attack. It just uses the same generic room for all the bosses. And then there's no teleporter in or out, so you just have to grab the life up to exit. Just fine. I like it more than having to teleport out, because then you can't possibly miss the life. It's like Nightman is like super lame when you have, when you know that you use the Amethyst Spear. And, you know, Centaur Man's pretty lame when he chooses not to use Centaur Flesh. Here's the guy we didn't use a special on. So this is just like the fight with Gyro Man, because he fights with, you know, shooting blades at you and stuff, and he flies out of reach from you, and you kind of use the same ability of just like the screen clearing attack to attack him from wherever he is. It's just kind of a battle of attrition at that point. Just hit him enough until he dies. Just a, like a waiting game. I think Tomahawk Man is the hardest one. Like, you don't know what attack he's gonna do until he does it, and good luck dodging whatever it is. For the boss rush. What is Wily weak to? I don't remember. I guess I'll remember when I get there. That's the hope, anyway. This guy with the flash real quick. Oh. They put him like just high enough this time where it's like it's difficult to hit him with it. Maybe they knew. Hey, a severed Mega Man head, just like you. I love this boss music. Not gonna do it. Oh, jeez. Alright, time to use all the E-tanks. Like, it's such a short loop on the song, but man, that's a good beat. That's probably my favorite Final Boss theme song in all the Mega Man games. So I guess technically this is the first time that they've ever actually been able to catch Dr. Wily and put him in jail. I assume maybe they were thinking at this point that, like, maybe this would be the last Mega Man game that they make in the Classic series, because, you know, they had another team that was working on Mega Man X, and that was going to be the future Mega Man, so maybe this storyline was, you know, best to try to wrap it up in some kind of meaningful way, in case it never come back to it again. And so you end with a pretty predictable conclusion of, well, they catch Wily, put him in jail, and that's the end of the story. Brothers happily ever after. All the robots get converted and have happy lives. But yeah. That's it for Mega Man 6. And I guess this is where I'll end the stream. Maybe I'll revisit on another stream. I'll play more Mega Man or Mega Man-esque games. So that would be fun. But yeah, until next time, thanks for watching. And